Good day, this is Jim Pytel from Columbia Gorge Community College. This is Digital Electronics. This lecture is entitled Counters in VHDL. Okay, so if you think designing and analyzing synchronous counters using D flip-flops as compared to JK flip-flops was easier, you haven't seen anything yet. We can also describe VHDL counters. I know we could use a structural description of using JK flip-flops hooked up in a such and such fashion with logic on those input gates to go ahead and implement a counter. But there's a far easier fashion. Again, there's this behavioral description methodology in VHDL that allows us to describe, given certain inputs, we just want these outputs to happen. And that's exactly what we're doing in VHDL. We are just taking these finite state machine diagrams and describing how they look. So what I've got here is our 2-bit gray code up counter finite state machine diagram. You take your finite state machine diagram and then you put it inside a case statement. If you want it positive edge triggered or negative edge triggered, what you do is you put that case statement inside an if statement. So what I've got here is I've drawn is an entity where it's got a clock input and a queue input output. Because I remember, I've got to read the state of the current position. Because again, what is this? It's a Moore machine. Its next state is dependent on its present state. And in this case, it's present state only. So it's a standard logic vector, two positions, Q1 and Q0. What I do is I have my architecture statement and I begin my architecture statement. I have a process. I begin my process. I ask the question first. If the clock tick event and the clock equals one, i.e. looking for a positive edge. If there's a positive edge, do this. If there's no positive edge, don't do this. Well, if there is a positive edge, what it's doing is going inside this case statement. When Q, case Q, when Q is 0, 0, implies that Q is assigned 0, 1. When Q is 0, 1, implies that Q is assigned 1, 1. When it's 1, 1, implies that Q is assigned 1, 0. When it's 1, 0, implies that Q is assigned 0, 0. And I've always got to have that catch-all statement, when others. When others, let's just say, start it right there. Okay, if it's got some erroneous, uninitialized, or unknown value, start at 0, 0, and hopefully it'll figure itself out. End the case statement, end the if statement, end the process, end the behavioral description of the architecture. It's that simple. All I did was take the finite state machine, and if it's positive or negative edge triggered, I've got to go ahead and do the if statement first, looking at the clock, but then all I do is the case statement describing it. All right, so how does this look like in a simulation? Here's a screenshot from the iSim Lite simulator. What I've got here is a clock that's got a positive edge there, 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 and there, and there. And what is its state? Well, it's unknown, i.e. others. Where does it go to? It goes to state, in this particular case, it's MSB2L. LSB, so it's 0, 0. Where does it go next? 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. It's doing that same count sequence as we had expected. Additionally, notice here, it's showing me in binary radix the vector Q1, Q0. So I don't necessarily need to expand those things out if I need to. But again, it's such a simple method of implementing a counter in VHDL. I'm just describing the finite state machine state diagram using a case statement. Let's go ahead and try another example. Okay, this is our old standby here. I've got a counter that when it's in zero mode, x equals zero, the external input x, I want it to go this fashion. And if it's in X1, I want it to go in this fashion. So again, all I'm going to do is I'm going to describe the behavior of this thing using the case statement. Let's look right here. I've got my library, my entity, and my architecture. Let's look at the entity. It's got an input X, an external input. It's got an input clock, and it's got an input output because I'm going to remember the state, my present state. I've got to read my present state. So based on the present state, its current present state, and the state of the external input X, I'm going to go ahead and advance to a next state. So let's go ahead and get to the meat of this thing here. It's the architecture statement. So the architecture statement, I am creating a case statement. Now, first off, what I'm doing is I am looking if there's a clock tick event and clock is equal to one, and if. So basically, it's looking for that positive edge of the clock. If there's no positive edge of the clock, don't do anything. And now what I'm doing is I'm doing that case statement, ending the case statement. But look at each when statement within that case statement. There's a decision. When it's currently in 0, 0, if x is 0, go to 1, 1. I'm doing this right here. Else, q goes to 0, 1, i.e. go this way. Let me go ahead and clean up our finite state machine diagram. So let's do that again here. When it's 0, 0, it's asking a question. When it's 0, 0, it implies ask the following question. If X is 0, then Q is assigned 1, 1. Else, because it's only asking this one question, if X is 0. If it's not 0, then it's assuming it's 1. Where does it go to? 0, 1. Each time you go ahead and assign something, each time you execute the expression for that case statement, just ask that single question. If it's X, do this. Else, do that. Okay, let's go ahead and do one more example within this case statement here. When it's 0, 1, where are we? We're right here. Ask the following question. If X is 0, where do we go? 1, 1. Go there. Else, go to 1, 0. Right there. Okay, so we're doing the X equals 1 path. And I should actually put that right there so it's not confusing. So go ahead and walk through this case statement. And you'll realize, okay, it's asking that same question. What's the value of X? And giving it one of those two paths. If you have two external inputs, you might have to have an if, else if, else if, else statement. Okay, ask those decisions if there's four separate paths through there. If you've got more than four paths, you're going to have to ask the question a couple more times. So these are substantially easier than any of the JK flip-flop, any of the D flip-flop implementations. We are giving VHDL a behavioral description of this thing and just letting it roll with it. So let's go ahead and do a quick look at a simulation of that same one. We've got our external input X, which is taking certain values. It's in one mode and it's in, let's go ahead and use the correct colors here. It's in one mode for this diagram, it's blue, and it's in red mode for that finite state machine diagram right there. We are currently, as we start off, we are in red mode. We are in state unknown. So what was it? It was when others go to state 00, our final statement in that case statement. If you go ahead and look back, so we were in an unknown state before, when others assign Q equals 00, i.e. that initial start state. So there we are, we're at 00. Positive edge occurs, where do we go? According to our diagram, we should be going to 1, 1. Where do we go? 1, 1. Next clock edge occurs, where should we be going? We should go to 1, 0. That's where we go. Okay, now we've switched over. We're in the blue mode, X equals 1, and we are in 1, 0. Where do we go to? As we'd expect, 1, 1. And now we are in the blue mode, we are in 1, 1. Where are we going to? 0, 1. And as you walk through these things, you'll realize as you switch modes, the thing is going to continually cycle in that pattern. Okay, substantially easier than the JK flip-flop or D flip-flop implementation of this, giving it its most basic description are these behavioral descriptions. So very similar to the JK flip-flops design of synchronous counters using JK flip-flops, design of synchronous counters using D flip-flops, I give you two suggested exercises. The first one is a 2-bit gray code / binary code up counter. Can you implement the case statement for that based on the external input and the present states? And then the other example I gave you was a 3-bit odd even up counter. Can you implement the counter description in VHDL based on that? Okay, you're going to go ahead. In both those cases, they have an external input. Your case statement may look something very similar to this. Okay, there's a certain state when this it implies. You're going to ask that question. If my external input is this, then do something else. Do something else. That's it. I mean, counters in VHDL, that's the advantage of VHDL. You're giving a major, major big picture behavioral description of it, and the VHDL code will, and its compiler will go ahead and implement these counters to perform exactly the behavior we're requesting.